Hey there. What if you worried every day for 6 months? Well, that would be a waste of 6 months now, wouldn't it? Hey, are you a worrywart? Everyone worries from time to time, and worry is a normal part of life. But do you feel you're starting to take things to a higher level? Are you suffering from chronic worry? Well, keep watching to learn how letting your worries rule your life for months on end can change your brain's pathways and increase your physical pain. You'll also discover the bright side of worrying. Hey, don't forget to click the subscribe button and turn on notifications to join us on the what? Bright side of life. All right, considering for a moment that worry is the interest you pay on a debt you may not even owe, let's jump right in. Counting down from number 11, you'll miss out on the beauty of the present. When you're worrying, your mind is always thinking of the future. What'll happen? How will I solve this? Will they fire me? Because all your mental efforts are focused on envisioning what's next, you can miss out on the here and now. Worrying for a long time can change how you perceive your life. Maybe you have a steady job, a family who loves you, and a bright future ahead of you. But worrying can prevent you from seeing it. Since worrying keeps you in your head, over time, it can make you appear selfish, ungrateful, and like you aren't a good listener as your mind seems to be on other things. Number 10. You might start worrying about unreasonable things. Hey, the more you worry, the bigger your apprehensions can get in your head and go beyond what's logical. Maybe you recently lost some weight, and your initial worry was about putting the weight back on. But maybe now, even though you haven't weighed yourself, you're convinced that you not only put the weight back on, but are heavier than ever. The more you worry about finding solutions, the less logical you'll become. You might find yourself making some very irrational decisions and choosing to do things that don't make any sense, which will make you stop trusting yourself and make you feel less confident. Number 9. People might start veering away from you. Now, who do you think people feel most attracted to? Those with confident, positive personalities? Or those who worry constantly and can't see the bright side of things? If you're constantly worrying, people are probably going to notice. They might try to help for a while and offer advice. However, if their words don't have any impact on you, they might give up and give you some space. When people hang out with friends, they want to vent about their problems but also have fun. If you become so worried that you can only vent, they might not see you as a positive influence anymore. Unconsciously, if a friend tells you about a worry they have, you might make them feel more anxious about it with your opinion. This can all take a toll on those closest to you because they'll bear the responsibility of stabilizing your mood. Number 8. Your personality could change. Worrying is like playing an addictive video game. The more you do it, the more difficult it is to stop, minus the fun. Worrying for long periods of time can develop into chronic worrying, and it can hijack your life. Many people believe that worrying can be like an addiction. If an addiction is taking over your life, you can expect to start acting differently. You'll probably become more reclusive and introspective, and you might stop enjoying the things you once loved. It can even get to the point where you start worrying about worrying, and that's where things get mind-boggling. If it reaches that point, it may begin to take a toll on your mental health. Number 7. You might develop depression or anxiety. Worrying that goes unchecked is very likely to develop into a condition like a generalized anxiety disorder. This is a state in which you start being afraid of all sorts of things. Maybe you were initially worried about your finances and how you were going to pay the rent this month, but now you're worried about completely unrelated things, like talking to people or what your friends think about you. With anxiety and depression comes a slew of unpleasant symptoms. Fatigue, a lack of concentration, oversleeping or insomnia, restlessness, and irritability. Number 6. You could experience panic attacks. The body isn't meant to deal with so much worry. At some point, it just becomes overwhelmed and snaps. That's when panic attacks come in. If you don't cope with the worry and dismiss it from your brain, the fear just builds and builds. Panic attacks are an intense fear response. It might feel like the world is coming to an end, but they usually begin to subside after 10 minutes. They're often accompanied by strong heart palpitations, an inability to breathe properly, sweating, trembling, and lightheadedness. Unfortunately, having a panic attack once can make a person worry about experiencing it again, thus contributing to more worry. Number 5. You'll have a tough time falling asleep. When your head is running through all the things that can go wrong with your goals and plans, it can be hard to get a good night's rest. Over time, this can become a big problem. Just a single night of poor sleep can throw your circadian clock out of whack. When your sleep is affected, everything you do during waking hours is affected too. If you begin night after night having bad sleep because of worry, you can expect to feel very low energy during your waking hours, which will affect your work, your mood, and how positive you feel about life in general. According to Dr. Bridget Gordon, a psychiatric doctor from New York, worry and anxiety can prevent us from reaching REM sleep, which is necessary for steady mental health. Number 4. You might get body pains. Think of how different your body feels when you're relaxed and at peace than when you're worried. You can't really escape how your body reacts to worry. Your heart rate speeds up, your muscles tense, your senses sharpen, and your body starts pumping adrenaline in preparation for a battle. The fight, flight, and freeze response gets activated, which is how your body responds to stress. But your brain doesn't know whether you're stressed because a car is about to hit you and you need to run, or because you're worried about whether you turned the stove off when you left home. As it can't make that distinction, worry can keep your body in a constant state of tension. And with tension comes body pain. Number 3. You could get a psychosomatic illness. A psychosomatic condition is one that's completely caused or exacerbated by a mental factor. What does that look like? Well, a person can develop chronic back pain because they're stressed with work, or get an eye tic because they worry about their finances too much. In this way, people's mental state directly affects their bodies. When it comes to those who deal with irritable bowel syndrome, it's believed that the condition is highly exacerbated by the person's emotions. It can also develop into something more serious. There have been even cases of people who claim to have experienced blindness because they have been suffering from high stress levels. Psychosomatic illness comes directly from stress, worry, and anxiety. Number 2. You'll hurt your brain. It's scary to think about it, but excessive worry can change your brain. You know that worry is linked to stress and anxiety. There are two parts in your brain that help you process anxiety: the amygdala and the hippocampus. According to the National Institute of Mental Health, one of the purposes of the amygdala is to alert the rest of the brain that a threat is present and trigger a fear or anxiety response. The hippocampus is the part of the brain that encodes threatening events into memories. When you worry or suffer from anxiety for a long time, your hippocampus begins to degenerate, and this leads to impaired functioning. In the long run, this can actually increase the risk of neuropsychiatric disorders like dementia. It is possible to reverse some of the damage caused by chronic worry and anxiety, though that would involve taking medication. Number 1. You'll miss out on the positive side of worry. What does worrying actually do for you? It's not just an evil force that wants to drain the happiness out of you like some sort of dementor. It's meant to be an alarm mechanism of sorts, something that helps you survive and tells you there might be a challenge ahead. Try exchanging the negative word worry with the positive word awareness. When a person worries in a healthy way, worry or awareness lets them know there's a challenge. The person prepares for it and they don't get caught off guard. This increases their chances of succeeding. If you are not aware of your weight, you might become obese. If you're not aware of your grades, you might fail a class. Worry then should force you to take positive action to solve a problem. Worry or awareness is just telling you, hey, Maybe you should plan for this big life change. Or maybe you should stop spending your money on fast food or your finances will take a toll. There's a bright side to everything. And if you think about how worrying or being aware is meant to help, not hinder you, you might be able to break the pattern of worry. Now, if you've been worrying for months, consider visiting a therapist, as they'll be able to help you keep worry at bay and get a more positive mindset. So, tell us, Brightsiders, what do you do to cope with worry? Let us know in the comment section. Don't forget to give this video a like, share it with your friends, and click subscribe to stay on the bright side.